Hey class, sorry I won't be able to be with you today in class. So I wanted to give you a breakdown of what we're looking at doing today. So we are starting a summative assignment today. Any questions that you do have, we will touch on tomorrow. There is also an attendance check-in for today that will be posted on Google Classroom that you need to fill out. So first and foremost, when you log into Google Classroom today, you'll see an assignment called Soapstone New Deal Summative. And when you go ahead and you click on that, there's three documents in there, okay? And all three of them you're gonna need to use. The first one, it says updated New Deal Soapstone documents, okay? And the second one is the Soapstone New Deal graphic organizer. You're gonna be filling out the graphic organizer as your summative assignment for this grade. So this is really where you're going to put all of your information, okay? So the first thing that you'll notice here at the top is the prompt. It says, how did the government and the US citizens deal with the impact of the Great Depression? That is the prompt that you're trying to figure out that you're going to answer at the end of this, okay? That you're going to be able to tell me all about, you know, how did the government and the US citizens deal with the Great Depression using the New Deal and things like that. How you're going to do that is by filling out these right here, which are called soapstones, all right? And in this soapstone, let me zoom in here so I can kind of show you. All right, you will see that a soapstone is just an acronym, okay? S stands for speaker, O stands for occasion, A audience, P purpose, S subject, and then tone stands for actually tone. For each document, you're going to fill this out, okay? What I've also done, the third attachment to your assignment is a picture actually of a poster from my classroom. And on this poster, it actually gives a good breakdown of each item. So speaker, occasion, audience, purpose, subject, and tone. And this is something that you're probably gonna wanna refer back to pretty frequently to be able to answer the questions. So for example, the speaker is the voice that tells the story or the article. This is the author. If it's a picture, it's the person that took the picture. If it's a speech, it's the person who's giving the speech, okay? For occasion, this is the time and the place and the context of the story of article, or excuse me, story or article. For this one, we're really looking for a date, okay? You might put a date in there. You might put, you know, what important thing was going on. So for some of these, you might be putting like 1933, Great Depression, something like that. The audience is, who is this meant for? Who is going to see this image? Who is going to see, or who was this image meant for? Who is this speech meant for? A lot of times it's going to be the American citizens, all right? The purpose is the reason behind the story or article. So like, why was this written? Why was this picture taken? Why was this speech given, all right? The subject is the story of the article in a few words or phrases, all right? What is this text about? Maybe it's about African-Americans during the Great Depression. Maybe it's about women during the Great Depression, something like that, okay? And then last but not least is the tone. This is the attitude of the author. How do they sound? How do they feel? Are they sad? Are they happy? Are they encouraging? That is kind of the goal for this one. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be looking at these documents. So there's five documents. All right. The first one is an image. Okay. That it kind of, it talks about the, let me zoom in there for a second. Sorry. It says New Deal remedies. So you're going to be talking about how the New Deal was set up to hopefully help the economy. Okay. This person here is the economy. Okay. This is FDR. Okay. And then you have Congress over here. But what you're going to do then with this document is you're going to basically tell me, and this one doesn't actually have a speaker on it. So for this one, it's okay to leave that blank if you can't find the speaker. Okay, so it doesn't have a speaker on it, that's okay. But you, what you're gonna be doing though, is you're gonna be filling out the rest of these. So what's the occasion here? Okay, well, I'm gonna look at this image a little bit more closely and I'm gonna see this, the purpose of this is to show all the different ways that FDR and Congress are going to try to fix the economy, okay? And all these little bottles down here are different programs that he's put together in the New Deal to help fix the economy, right? Who is this meant for? This picture, who is this? Who is the audience? Okay, what's the purpose? What's the subject? What's the tone? You're gonna do that for all of these documents. And you'll notice that it just goes down, document two, document three, document four, and document five. Now, the other thing that you have to do for each document, if I scroll over here, is you'll notice this question. It says, according to this document, how did the government or US citizens deal with the impact of the Great Depression? Okay, for this one, all we want you to do is, based on this document, okay, how are people dealing with it? So for example, there's one picture of like a bread line. Well, people are helping other people by trying to provide them with food, things like that. Okay, so that's what you're going to want to put in the application section here. When you're all done with that part, you're going to scroll down to the bottom and you are going to write a thesis statement based on the prompt. Okay, you are going to write a thesis statement based on the prompt. So that is the, you know, the topic. So the claim again, if we go back up to the top, it says, how did the government and the US citizens deal with the impact of the Great Depression? You're going to answer that question. You're going to say, the government and the US citizens dealt with the impact of the Great Depression by blank, blank, and blank, or blank and blank. Okay, so you're just going to give me one thesis statement. All right. Now, the one last thing, and I probably should have talked about this first, I don't know why I skipped over it, I'm sorry, is the contextualization part, which is the background knowledge. You have to provide me with some background knowledge of the Great Depression and New Deal. So right over here, it says, what do you already know about the Great Depression and the New Deal from our previous classes and your own readings? Okay, include facts like definitions, dates, people, organizations, places, etc. You're just going to answer these questions. Who was involved in the Great Depression? You should have names like FDR or Hoover in here. Where did it happen? What happened and why? Okay, so we should have a conversation there about the stock market and the differences between Hoover and FDR and things like that. This whole thing is worth 40 points. Okay, it is going to be due on Thursday by the end of class. We are going to spend a lot of time, or we're going to spend the entire time tomorrow working on it in class, as well as the entire class on Thursday. I will repeat a lot of this information on Thursday, or I'm sorry, tomorrow as well. But I do want you guys to get started on this today and be working on it. The goal for today should be pretty much to finish the background knowledge, as well as the probably at least one of the documents. That would be kind of a good place to start today. All right. If you do have any questions, I should be able to answer by email, kfitzgerald@jths.org, or you can always send me a message on Remind. All right, guys. So if you have any questions, let me know. Other than that, I hope you have a good rest of your day and I will see you later. Adios.